Hey, what's up? It's Comic95. I have heard the absolute most ridiculous thing I've ever heard of recently this year. So, I oftentimes, probably the most asked question is, oh my god, what are Japanese guys like? Tell me about Japanese guys. Today, I was looking at the Japan Times, which if you're not familiar with it, it is an online newspaper that's in English. They tell politics, you know, what's going on in Japan from a leftist perspective for the most part, and from an American perspective. I'm pretty sure that most of the editors and or at least the founders of the company probably were American because of how the news is told. It's heavily, you know, biased, if you will. They try to make it unbiased though. So, off of that, there was an article in which it was a girl who wrote in a question, and she was asking if she was wrong to have not gone to her Japanese boyfriend's house for the first date. And I guess they weren't quite exactly official yet. Well, she says that after she didn't go, he ghosted her. And I could not believe the fact that, one, she was questioning the situation, and the fact that the commenters were so lost. Everyone in the comments is saying, oh, you know, it's culture, you know, yeah, that's why he, you know, left you, blah, blah, blah. Let me enlighten you. That is absolutely not culture. No Japanese man, absolutely no man. I don't care how much he likes you, loves you, whatever. I don't care if you marry him. No normal, honest man is going to invite you to his home for the first date. Let's get into it. First of all, culturally, for Japanese people, they do not even invite their friends to their home. Apartments here are super, super small. They're tiny. There is no space to accommodate other people. Most people do not have fancy entertainment to entertain guests. There isn't a lot of space. Normally, you don't even have the room to have a bed that stays out all day. This is just not something that you do, and especially not for a first date. Why would you want a stranger in your personal space, in your home? What if he or she is crazy? What if they try to, you know, rape you or make you do stuff you don't want to do? Why would you go there? And why would you want them in your place? So, not just that, a hotel. This was another question. You will never go to a love hotel or anything like that for the first date. Do not fall for lies. It is very common for a Japanese guy who is enough of a pig to ask you to go to one of these places for him to say something like, oh, like, let's just go to a love hotel to talk. Let's just play video games. You know, I'll just watch. I won't touch you. I'll sleep on the floor. Bullshit. Do not do that for a few different reasons. For starts, you're giving off bad and wrong signals. So it doesn't matter if the guy, you know, doesn't, you know, lose control over himself and he doesn't touch you. That doesn't matter. It doesn't matter if, you know, you are close to him, like you live near, you feel like you're safe. No, he would never ask a Japanese girl to come to his place. And a very easy way to solve this, I literally say that, I'm not just saying it to you. Before my current boyfriend, anytime I would talk to a guy online and, you know, we get to texting, and he asked me to do something that I felt was inappropriate, even by my own country standards in America, I always said, would you ask a Japanese girl that? And they always say either no or, oh, I'm so sorry, I don't mean it like that, I'm not gonna do, like, yeah, bullshit. They would never say that. And if you ask, if you have, you know, a Japanese dad like I do, or, you know, female friends or whoever, you ask them, like, hey, is this normal to ask, you know, whatever, they will tell you right away, red flag, absolutely not. Because no Japanese girl in her right mind would ever go to a man's house that she doesn't know, just met. And to be honest, they will not ask you to do that for at least the first few dates or so. You need to keep in mind, as a foreign girl, Japanese guys are just as curious about you as you are curious about them. So a lot of the time, girls, myself included, I'll admit, you know, we look up and we search, like, oh, you know, Japanese guys are so cute, I want to see what they're like, what is it like to date a Japanese guy, are they like tuxedo mask, you know, stuff like that. They do the exact same thing. They have, you know, fetishes and fascinations with you, probably way more than you could, you know, ever imagine. They have a love for foreign women, and they believe stereotypes. They think that you are all whores. You're all some, you know, Hollywood sex doll is how they view you. They think that, you know, Americans in particular, since I'm an American, my perspective, they think that foreigners, you know, Americans, that they all just have, like, a big fucking orgy together, excuse my language, that they all just have sex all day, nonstop. They love one-night stands, they'll sleep with anybody. They look at all these movements that we have going on with, you know, body empowerment and stuff, and girls dressed, you know, half naked, etc. And they're like, oh my God, these women are so sexy, please fuck me. That's how they see it. It is not viewed the way that you would like for it to, where you think that you're being positive or whatever, and you're embracing your body. Instead, to Japanese people here, it's like, oh my God, easy slut, sexy foreign hoe. I wanna fuck this chick, take pictures of her, and tell my whole gang, I smashed. Do you wanna run a train? That is what they're going to do, and I kid you not. I've literally gone on dates with guys in which they would ask if they could take a picture with me so they could send it to their friends. Actually, I have an even more embarrassing story. I will admit, I had a one-night stand with a Japanese guy before, and after we were done having sex, he literally asked me if he could take a picture with me while we're in bed to send to his friends. What the literal fuck? Who asked that? I went on another date with a Japanese guy, and he tells me that him and his friends were celebrating the loss of his friend's virginity to a foreign girl. What type of shit is that? And this is not just, you know, a one-off thing. Totally normal here. A lot of people do that. And what I mean by a lot of people, anyone who's using these apps, Tinder, Scout, whatever you're using, OkCupid, they're on these apps looking for foreign women, which is why a lot of their profiles are written in English. They're not even trying to attract a Japanese girl. A lot of them even specify that they only want to speak to foreign women. They don't want, you know, Japanese girls to mess with them or to like them. That's a red flag right there. A guy that doesn't even like, you know, his own race, that has decided that he specifically wants just white girls, just black girls, just whatever, anything besides Asian. There's a red flag right there. You do not want to mess around with someone like that. And the main reason why they like you is for two reasons. One, they're not seen, or maybe more. One, they're not seen as attractive to Japanese women. Maybe he's too short, too fat, his skin is too dark, he doesn't have nice hair, his eyes are small, whatever the case is. But our standards of beauty are so different, just like theirs are. So what they consider as unattractive, you might think, oh my God, he's the cutest guy in the world, but here in Japan, he's average, he's meh. And people feel that way about a lot of the guys that I've dated, my friends. I'm both Japanese, Chinese, and Korean. They'd be like, you like that guy? He's not cute. And I'm like, oh my God, he's the cutest thing in the world. And so, like, when I'll show them pictures of the guy that I would be dating, they'd be like, you went on a date with him? Like, ew, he's not cute. They've literally just liked maybe four or five people that I've showed them that I liked. So, again, same thing goes for you. You know, what you consider as attractive, they might not, more than likely do not think is cute here. So to that guy, it's like, oh my God, you know, I might be ugly, but I get to score this, you know, hot foreign girl that I can show off to my friends, you know, etc. Another red flag. They oftentimes will ask for you to lie about how you met. So they'll try to quickly introduce you to people, which is also a red flag. They'll try to, you know, let you meet their friend or meet, you know, whoever, someone that's close to them, so that they can show them that, you know, they're hanging out with a foreigner. I went out on a date with a guy, and while we're on the date, we went out for nachos. We had Mexican food. He tells me that his friend is going to be coming and coaches me to lie and say, you know, that we met at, you know, the station or whatever, like Shinjuku station or something. And so I'm thinking, like, what? What is the purpose of me lying about this for? Like, I'm not your girlfriend. Turns out, when I get there, he's telling this guy that I'm his girlfriend. And he's talking about how we met at Shinjuku, so his friend could actually speak a little bit of English. And so back then, I knew no Japanese. And so he, you know, says to me, he's like, girlfriend? Girlfriend? You love him? Like, he's saying stuff like that. And I'm like, I just met this guy a few minutes ago. And so I don't know what else they said, but it couldn't have been positive. But you will deal with weird stuff like that. So anyway, my point is, they think that you're easy. It's not every guy, of course. Again, I've dated Japanese guys. Every relationship that I've had has not been bad. My current boyfriend is just the absolute best in the world, and he's not like that. I'm not saying all Japanese guys are like that. But what I am saying is, do not be stupid and naive. That is not culture. Japanese men will never, ever, ever invite you to their house for the first, second, not even third date. That is not normal to do here, because a Japanese girl would never even okay that. They will not ask you for inappropriate pictures. They will not ask you, you know, to do anything weird like that. They know, or they think they know, that this is okay in your culture. So they're purposefully being rude and disrespectful by Japanese standards because they think it's okay by your country's standards. They think they can get away with it. So I were you, I would absolutely try my absolute best to stay away from any guy's house. I would never in a gazillion years ever go to any man's house that I don't know. Do not go to a hotel with him. If you absolutely must, you want to have a one-night stand and do your thing, hey, go ahead. You're better off going to a love hotel because there's more security if something goes wrong. You can leave much more easily. But to be honest, even the craziest of Japanese guys, even if he is, you know, nasty, a pig, a liar, not really trying to date you, just trying to fuck, I will say this. At least, you know, if you tell them that you want them to leave or they're being inappropriate and you tell them, like, stop or whatever, they will stop. They listen. And I cannot say the same thing about American guys. I will say that if you nip it in the bud and you talk to them directly, they will back down and apologize. They will not fight or persist. Stuff happens, I know, but I'm saying in general, you don't have to deal with that. So I don't really say this out of like a fear of like to protect you, but I'm saying to not be stupid. Do not let some guy lie to you and say that this is culture, it's a normal thing to do. It is never, ever, ever normal for them to insist that you have your first date or any, you know, date for that matter at their place. Only go if you absolutely want to and you're expecting to have sex. Because that is the other thing too. Here in Japan, if a girl and a guy are going to each other's house, they're in a relationship and they're having sex. That's already decided. You do not go over a guy's house just to hang out, just to have fun. If he's inviting you over his house, that's code for, I am going to convince you into having sex with me. It might start off casual, but it is going to lead into sex. It's gonna happen, I promise you. And if it doesn't happen, you probably said or did something that made him change his mind and have second thoughts. Or, you know, you weren't getting the signs that he was trying to give you. No honest man, no honest Japanese man is going to invite you to his home. Japanese culture is not like Western culture. They do not have company over their houses. That's totally taboo. It's not a normal thing to do. Do not fall for that. Do not believe that. If he ghosts you afterwards, that's proof, sweetheart. He was using you. He just wanted to have sex. And because you turned down his invitation to fuck, what does he want to do with you anymore? You're of no use to him anymore. He just wanted to experience having sex with you. Maybe, you know, he has a thing for blonde hair, blue eyes. Maybe, you know, he wants to be with a black girl. Maybe he thinks you're going to twerk for him. Maybe he likes big breasts, big booties. Whatever he has going on, he thinks you're Rihanna or Beyonce. Whatever he has that he has a fetish for or over, he wants that to be fulfilled. He wants to check you off of his bucket list, take pictures, and show his friends. You do not want to mess around with a guy like that. And to be honest, you did yourself a favor. No matter how much you think you like the guy, he was trying to play you. He wasn't serious about you. Because if he was, he would have apologized and made the date somewhere else happily. He would have said, oh, I'm sorry, I don't mean it that way. Let's go to a cafe. We don't have to kiss, have sex, nothing. I just want to meet you. That's much better. So again, and of course that can turn sexual too. But now you've met him face to face. You didn't go to his house. You're in a casual setting. You probably got a free meal out of it. You know, there's no real loss here, so to speak. And you can be much more trusting towards someone that's willing to meet you in a public place. The fear here isn't someone murdering you or raping you, like how fear in America, but more so the guy is trying to play you. He thinks you're an idiot. He thinks you're a stereotypical, easy foreign girl. They mostly believe that foreign women are a lot more open sexually because, like this, we dress more sexy than Asian women do. Our bodies are generally curvier than theirs are. And by Asian beauty standards, you're the most beautiful thing in the world. You have pale skin, you have big colorful eyes, you have long blonde hair, you have everything they want in a woman. It's like you're not even real. You're literally a live, you know, blow up doll, a sex doll, is how they see you. And on top of that, to make matters even better, wow, they even have an app to meet foreigners and have sex with them. That's all you are to this guy. Can somebody that you meet and have sex with on the first date, can it lead to marriage? Yes, it does happen. It doesn't, you know, make you a hoe because you had sex on the first date or the 20th date. That's not my point. But my point is if a guy's trying to dope you into going to his house, he's lying to you, it's not culture, he's playing you. And if he says, oh, I didn't mean it that way, he knew he meant it that way, and he knew it was going to be taken, well, he knew it should be taken that way, but he didn't expect you to be smart enough to understand that, because you'd be amazed at how many foreign girls stupidly just don't know this stuff. just because a guy takes you on a date here, just because he pays for the date, just because he says, oh, I love you, I love foreign girls, I love this country, oh, you're American, oh, you're Italian, I used to study French, you know, whatever, blah, 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 don't buy that stuff. He said this to a million different girls. You are not the first, only, or last girl that he's seen. He sees foreign girls all the time, and he will find another one, which is exactly why he's gonna ghost you. So, another thing you don't wanna do, that's gotta suck. You think that you have a real boyfriend, you go to his place, you end up feeling pressured into having, you know, sex with him, and then he leaves you afterwards. Have morals, set standards for yourself, protect your own body and your own heart. Do not let a guy pressure you and claim that it's culture. And if it was culture, you should tell him that he should respect your culture too, and that you're not okay with doing that. If he loves you, if he thinks he loves you and wants to take a chance with you, he'll understand. So, that's that. Please stay safe, ladies. Do not, you know, get yourself dragged into a situation that you don't want to be in. Do not go to a guy's house on the first date. It's not culture. It is a lie. That's that. Thank you so much for watching. This is Comic95, the Savior. Please like, comment, and subscribe. And you can follow me on Instagram and Twitter at Comic95 as well. Please send me any of your questions that you may have by email, or you can leave a comment down below and I will try to read them. And again, I'm not bashing anybody. You know, if that's your thing, you wanna, you know, you like one night stands, you like to mess around with guys like that, go ahead. I'm not judging you. But I am saying, you know, don't do this thinking that this is how you get relationships here. It can turn into one, but you're really just making a fool out of yourself for the most part, because they would not be able to find a Japanese girl that's willing to do that. It's not normal here. It's culturally strange. So, that's that. Thank you so much for watching. Bye.